Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be following on from part 1 and 2 of the layers Photoshop tutorials and just building up our skills and understanding the layers property panel and some of the tools around it. So what I've done is I've got a series of images from the internet, and I'll put links in the description for you for that. And the plan is to combine the images together to make a new scene. So what I'm going to do is add some balloons, following on from our last tutorial, using the selection tool and cutting the balloons out of the background. I'm going to use a mask to remove the sky and use the different clouds, and then maybe an adjustment layer to change the colors a little bit, but we'll see as we go on. So as you can see, I've got this background of a mountain range, and I want to start by changing the clouds. So I've got this, well, I've got a few cloud ones, you can find your own. Just going to pull over the actual clouds, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold shift and make it a lot bigger, bring it down to about here like so, and then just check roughly that it's covering where I want to rub out the clouds. And that we'll double click the layer, call it clouds, unlock the background, call that land by double clicking the title, and then we'll move the clouds. Let's move it below the land. So when we're on the land, what I want to do is I want to be able to rub out the actual clouds, revealing the clouds before, but we're going to do it as a mask. So it means if we go wrong, we can rub the parts we rub out of the mountain back in. So it's kind of, and you can actually do it, this is different opacities as well. But while we're on the land, go down, and this is in your layers panel, there's this little rectangle with a circle in it. Click that and you get this. So make sure you what it's selected, this is your mask. And then if you go over to your toolbar, make sure you've got black and white selected here. So when I rub, when I use the brush tool, so if you come down, 8th, 9th tool down, and you start rubbing, what it does, it deletes the background that's linked to the mask. So you can see there's a little black area. So what this is doing, it's just rubbing out the transparency of that image. So if I switch these around and go white and black, it will rub it back in. So it's just like if I go, if I was going round and I went like that, and you think, oh, you could literally, you know, you can undo it, but you could do this as well. I mean, this is a basic way of using, one basic way of using masks, which I find quite useful. So what you would do is you would carry on rubbing into all this. So when it gets to this part out to the mountains, it's quite tricky. So what we'll do is we'll just make a selection, I think, of the actual mountain range to stop us going through this. So I'll go up to this corner here, look with these three little dots in an arrow, which is the history, which is under window history. Let's go back to when we've added the layer, make sure we're on the layer mask, and let's just make a basic selection. So if you go down to where we use, if you remember, we used in the last tutorial the object selection, let's just go and use, well, I'll tell you what, because we've used that before, let's go one above and we'll use the magnetic lasso tool. So what this is going to do is I'm going to click, and what it's going to do, it's going to cling this selection to the pixels that stand out. So you might miss a few. So if you miss a few, it's best to zoom in, which I'm not, is if you press backspace, you can go back. So, and every now and then, just click the left mouse to lock a point in position. And then again, if you go wrong, so if I go like this, and I can see I've missed some here, backspace, keep pressing backspace till you bring you back to where you are, and just keep pressing the actual mouse button, locking in the positions. And just, like I say, take your time, I'm rushing through, missed a bit there, look, go back. But again, zoom in, which I'm not. So I want to try and get this done quickly to show you what I mean. But missed a bit there. And you don't have to keep clicking, it's up to you. And we'll keep going, going, going. So it's not going to be perfect, but you'll get the gist of it. down there, nearly there, and then all I'm going to do is come all the way back to here like that. Now I've done that just because I just want to rub the bottom part out. I'm not bothered about making a selection, so I go back to my brush, and what I'm doing is I'm just doing this like so. Okay, and then I'm not bothered about the selection anymore, so Control D to deselect, and then I can rub out the rest with the actual brush tool. Not worried about this mountain range too much now, because I've got the area I want, and you can see the black area covering in here. Okay, but like I said, at any time, if you switch the colours around, as long as you're on the actual mask, you can draw back in the original clouds and stuff. So there we go. So we've got our land with a mask on it, and we've got a cloud, which looks all right. Let's but I know I'm happy with them now, so let's go and add another image. So let's add a balloon. Well, let's do this one. I'm going to pull it up into the bar here, look, add it on its own layer. So once it's actually in Photoshop, what we need to do is make a selection using the selection, the rectangle selection tool that we've done in the second Photoshop tutorial. Makes a selection. There's little bits at the bottom, maybe not as good as we want, but yeah, let's just use the move tool. The selections in, I'm just going to drag and drop it into our scene here like so. So obviously it's in between, which actually quite nice, it's in between the two layers originally did, which I'm going to leave it there, I weren't planning on. Let's just free transform it, so Control T, holding shift, let's pull it down and let's put it so it's kind of here, a bit smaller, so it's behind. But what we'll do is we'll reduce the opacity down to, let's say, 75%. So it gives the illusion that it's kind of in the clouds right back there. I mean, could be up to about 80 maybe. Do you decide? But there's the first balloon. Leave it like that, which is all right. Don't need that. Let's go and get another one. This one. Okay, again, same tool. Object selection, draw around it, it's clung to it, looks okay. It's missed little bits off again, which again you can come in here and do it, but I'm going to do this quickly just so you know what I'm doing. Again, let's this time pull it above so it's on top, so I just dragged and dropped it above, and let's just free transform that down. Let's say we want this one here, like so. We'll leave that there. And what we can do, shut that, is again, we'll put one more. And again, it's up to you to get what images you want and decide on what else you want in the scene. So let's do this one now. Again, let's go round. So about right, it's just missed the top bit off here, so let's click select and mask, and let's make sure I'm minus to remove it, and let's just go and clean this up a little bit badly like so. And again, if you want to come in here and clean it up, you can. Let's come over here, let's just simply tell the selection to be on a new layer. I'll do, and then we can move that layer over and then place it where you want, I suppose. I mean, if you want it close up, you're going to have to come in here and clean all this up. But let's just hold shift, free transform it down. I can see I've missed bits here. Let's put this up here somewhere. And let's turn the opacity down again, see a little bit. What's that? So just a little bit through. Like so. Now The other thing you can do, so I've got, you can carry on working on this, is if you wish, let's go to the actual, so I'm not going on the actual mask, I'm going on the image itself. And we've used a mask here, and next to it, you've got this little kind of circle, half black, half white. So create a new adjustment layer. So what adjustment layer does, it adds a layer that's linked to the layer you want to change. And it's where you can add stuff to it without actually changing the original image. So it's like non-destructive editing really. So let's say I wanted to just do brightness and contrast. So what it'll do is, if we just go back, you'll notice that there's a layer above this layer with the little adjustment layer icon and saying it's linked. And then the properties for it is here. So if I wanted to, I could adjust the brightness and contrast like so. Like that. Which, again, if I turn it off. So that's adjustment layer for the layers here. If you don't want that, let's pull this. I mean, if I pulled that above it now, you're just going to get the whole lot above it. But again, like I say, that's linked to that layer there, so it's adding the adjustment to that layer. And obviously because there's a mask with the cloud adapted and the blue in between it, it affects that as well, but it doesn't affect the other two. Okay, well, that's, again, you've got, we'll do more of that on our next, one of our next tutorials and stuff, but that's it for this tutorial, really. I just wanted to go through basic adding a mask, and again, recapping on the tutorials again. So just as a recap, we've covered dragging and dropping layers, making selections of them. We've made a mask to remove the actual clouds and add the different cloud layer from below. We've done a little bit of adjustment layer to change the colors slightly to composite this together. So that's it for this tutorial. Please look out for my next tutorial. Please share, subscribe, and thanks for listening.